With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Well, hello students, now we're going to see this question. The question says that water from tap emerges vertically downwards, okay, with initial speed of 3 meter per second, okay. So the cross-sectional area of the tap is 10 to the power minus 4 meter square. Okay, assume that the pressure is constant throughout the stream of water, okay, and the flow is steady. The cross-sectional area of stream 2 meters below the tap is. So basically we need to find the cross-sectional area below the stream. So basically what will be, basically if you see properly, then you can find the rate of flow. So what will be basically the rate of flow? The rate of flow so what will be basically the rate of flow rate of flow will be rho into g into h. Okay, this h is basically whatever this 2 meters. Okay, so rho will be basically 10 to the power 3 kilogram per meter cube. Okay, so let's name this rate of flow is this basically. So into basically g, which is 10 meter per second square, into height, which is minus 2 meters basically, but let's write it 2 meters. Okay, so what we're going to get from here, we're going to get basically 2 into 10 to the power 4. 2 into, so basically if you see from here, we are going to get 2 into 10 to the power 4. Okay, basically after cutting everything, what we'll get? Kg, only kg, yeah, kg per second. Kg per second. Okay, this is what we're gonna get, but let's remove this for now. And also we know the rate of flow.
So what you can write basically rate of flow for, if you think about one more equation, it's that rate of flow basically, rate of flow is basically equal to density into V2 minus V1 halved and V2 basically square minus V1 square. So this is basically the rate of flow. This formula is also given in our books. So what we'll write from here, half into, let's write it 10 to the power 3, okay, into V2 square, basically we don't know, so we'll just leave it at V square, okay. And V1 square is initial velocity, which is basically 3 meter per second, so it will be basically 9, okay. So now you can see from equation 1 and equation 2, we can equate it because both are same quantities. So from here what we'll get, half into, let's write equating 1 and 2. Got it? So what we're gonna get from here is basically 2 into 10 to the power 4 will be equal to half into 10 to the power 3 V square minus 9. Okay, this is what we're gonna get. So if we take this 2 over here, we'll get 4. So what we're gonna get, 4, and basically this will cut this, so it will be 40 will be equal to V square minus 9. Okay, this will be our initially. So what we'll get basically, V square will be equal to 49. Okay, from here we'll get V will be equal to 7 meter per second. Okay, so since we got V is equal to 7 meter per second, now we're going to use one last equation, that is the equation of continuity. Okay, equation of continuity. Okay, this is the equation that we're going to use. What is basically the equation of continuity? Equation of continuity is nothing but A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2, where A is area and V is velocity. So what was A1? A1 was basically this, 10 to the power minus 4. Okay, and so we are gonna write it over here. A1 was basically 10 to the power minus 4. And what was V1? V1 was basically 3. Okay, and basically what was A2? A2 was basically this. A2 was what we have to find. Okay. And what was V2? V2 was basically this. V2 is basically this, so it will be 7. Okay, so what we are going to get from here, A2 will be equal to 3 by 7 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square. Okay, so this is what we're gonna get, that A2 is equal to this. Since A2 is equal to this, this is what we are, our answer is. So if you want to find in points, then you can find 7 divided by 3. Okay, so what you're gonna get, you're gonna get 0 point, and basically 7 times 3 is 21, but 4 is 28. So 28, which you will get 2, and again you will get 2, so we'll get 14. And basically you have to divide it again and again and again. So this is 66 basically. So you will get a 60 over here. So lastly I'll do this. So you will get 7 times 5. 7 times 7 is 49. And 7 times 8 is basically 56. So you will get 8888. So let's conclude that it will be 4.28 into 10 to the power minus 5 meter square. Okay. So in points also I found the answer, and in fraction also. Okay, so this is basically our final answer. Okay, this will be our answer. Okay, thank you so much.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubtnet app today.